New tonight at 5, Northport police say Brian Laundry was under surveillance before he disappeared.
Josh Taylor, who represents the city of Northport, spoke to CNN. He said his agency kept an eye on Gabby Petito's fiance as best they legally could before he went missing.
I mean, the guy goes for a walk in the Carlton Reserve. He's not wanted for a crime. What are we supposed to do? We're going to go tree to tree, following him back through the woods? I mean, it just wasn't there with the information we had in this case.
Okay, but then why did the Northport Police Chief, Todd Garrison, say this on September 16th?
Do you know where Brian Laundry is right now?
Yes.
So that was September 16th. Chief Garrison said that police did know where Brian Laundry was at that point. But the next day, Brian's parents reported him missing, and later they acknowledged they hadn't seen him for 4 days. Police may not have had enough evidence to arrest Brian at that point, but it's also clear that they did not know where he was, contrary to what the chief just said. Here we are, 3 weeks later, and still no sign of Brian. Now, Brian is, of course, a person of interest in the death of his fiancée, Gabby Petito. And tonight, a man with no connection to Gabby wants to build a permanent memorial in her honor.
Just to be able to share my gift with others and to help, you know, help her memory. This is where I believe I need to, you know, give back.
The temporary memorial right now is outside Northport City Hall.
And that is where NBC2's Samantha Serban is live tonight after speaking exclusively with the artist. Samantha.
Well, this is a site to grieve, remember, and honor Gabby Petito. But all of these things here at this memorial can easily be messed up by the elements. These were all brought in dedication of Gabby. Aaron Betzner is working on something permanent to honor the 22-year-old whose story touched so many.
Teddy bears, candles, butterflies, and a wooden cross. They all stand in the grass out in front of Northport City Hall, a solemn reminder that life is precious.
This is where I believe I need to, you know, give back.
Indiana architect Aaron Besner was captivated by the tragedy of 22-year-old Gabby Petito's death, like thousands of others around the world. He's never seen the Northport Memorial in person, but plans to add to it, not with his words or music, but with his craft.
I'm a steel fabricator. I'm an architect by trade. And being blessed with the gifts that I had been given, with my ability to work with metal and create and work with my hands, it resonated with me and said that this was something that I needed to do.
Creating something permanent with the help of Gabby's family, Betzner is building a bench.
Just to be able to share my gift with others and to help, you know, help her memory.
It'll take several weeks to complete, but Betzner will bring it from Indiana and install it in the same park personally. He couldn't find the words to say he's sorry for the Petito family's loss, so instead,
I try to stay positive. I try to stay focused on the actual creation of something special, and try to make it as positive as I possibly can.
The final design is still being drafted between Betzner and Gabby's family. Count on NBC2 to bring it to you when it's completed.
Samantha, it's really incredible to see her story impact strangers everywhere. I'm wondering, is this a city project or a personal one?
This is a personal one for Betzner. He said he heard Northport's mayor, Jill Luke, talk about the possibility of a permanent memorial, and she threw out the idea of a bench, and he hopped on board, calling her and offering to make it out of the goodness of his heart. There is no city funding going toward this, no taxpayer dollar, just something Betzner says he felt called to do. Live in Northport, Samantha Serban, NBC2.
All right, Samantha.